All right. Merry Christmas, y'all. And to all, a Merry Christmas. Your counselor is coming from the store, doing the grandpa thing, you know. In other words, it's the also like the fatherhood thing. What a wonderful joy to see us men, especially, you know, real men coming across, going to the store and providing for these grandbabies and these children. One thing I have to say about it is that there's a misconception going on and a confusing thing that we've been doing for many years. We've been somewhat tricked to do it and not even seeing the real full impact of damage that we can do to these kids. We got this image going on that Santa Claus is a fat, overweight, obese white man, you know, with toys to, if you be good, you know, the fat white man is going to come. But I'm here to say that, look at me, I'm Santa Claus. And you all are Santa Claus. And it's not a fat white man, you know what I'm saying, in the red and white suit, bringing these kids their correct presents. What damage happens as time goes on is that children will begin to grow up believing in fairy tales and not reality. They will grow up believing that, you know, daddy didn't do anything for us. And abusive relationships and mothers, because of their issues with fathers, will begin to tell the children that your daddy didn't do anything for you. You know, that I did everything or they did everything, you know, and that is damaging. Later on, that will become disrespect. Why should I respect you, daddy? Why should I listen to you, daddy? Because mama told me that Santa Claus did everything and daddy didn't do anything, you know. And question is that the truth? If it is the truth, it might sound better coming from him if he's available to answer his own question, you know, and instead of poisoning the minds of the child, you know. Children need both parents, you know, and both parents are not always able to bring Christmas or these holidays to these children, right? Other misconceptions and poisoning is when one watches these cartoons and superheroes. Most of these superheroes don't look anything like us, right? They don't. You know, it goes on to be the same as Christmas is, you know, a misconception of the truth. Ask yourself, do you want to keep feeding the kids or your kids the lie, or do you want to give them the truth? Because there's a real rough world out there. And going at it with a misconception and a lie is not going to help them. You know, you may think it is, but it's not going to help them. It makes them believe in fairy tales and different stuff like that, you know. You know, and where's the truth? I often even think of these Grand Theft Auto games and stuff like that. You know, shoot 'em up, bang, bang. You know, driving down the street, shooting innocent people, or even shooting police officers and all this kind of stuff. That is not anything that you really want to feed your child, you know, because they will believe that they can go out and do it too. You know, no one's showing them the court process. No one's showing them the prison process of what happens after all that goes down. Yeah, it's fun for a minute, and it seems to be fun. But fun is danger. That kind of fun is danger. And so we need to bring reality to our children and tell them the truth, you know, and quit saying, quit feeding them lies. And then later on, when they become liars, you know, you saying you want to beat them to death, you know. And then they say, well, where did you get all this lie stuff from? And they come at you and say, I got it from you. Didn't you lie to me about Santa Claus? Didn't you tell me Santa Claus was a fat, obese white man. Didn't you, mama? Didn't you, daddy? So let's come with the truth. And you can still have a good Christmas. You know, reality. You know, matter of fact, take them to the store and show them who bought the stuff. You know, they still get to play with it. You know, you don't have to play with it with a lie and a fantasy and a fairy tale. All right, yours truly, the counselor, Mr. James Horton.